Hello, I'm Raggy Omar and you're watching Witness. Coming to terms with a dark past is as difficult for societies as it is for individuals. In Argentina, the darkness of the military dictatorship that ruled from 1976 to 1983 lies in the stories of Los Desaparecidos, the disappeared. For decades, the kidnapping of opponents of the military junta who were then tortured before disappearing, never to be seen again, has gone unacknowledged by successive governments. But now, these stories and the experiences of those who survived are finally coming to light. And for those who lived to tell the tale, talking of their experiences has been extraordinarily painful. Enrique Sanchez was tortured for 12 months in a clandestine concentration camp. His torturers were the Paraguayan police working alongside the Argentinian military as part of Operation Condor, a South American intelligence network. But now, 30 years on, Enrique finally feels able to tell his story. The World and the Underworld is a powerful, personal film made by Enrique's nephew, Rodrigo Vasquez. It's a very moving film which lifts the veil on the reality of torture.
The military dictatorship that ruled Argentina from 1976 to 1983 produced 30,000 disappearances. An entire generation was lost during these years of oppression, the years of lead. These are the children of the disappeared. They spent years struggling to get those responsible for their parents' deaths behind bars. Asesino! Asesino! On March the 24th, 1976, the Argentine military staged a coup and launched a war on communism backed by the US government. That day, young political activists, union leaders, teachers, intellectuals, and artists began to be kidnapped, tortured, and eliminated. They became known as the disappeared. Their mothers, desperate to discover what had happened to their children, took to the plazas to protest these arrests and seek justice. In 2003, Argentine selected Néstor Kirchner as president. He promised to bring those responsible for the years of repression to justice. In 2004, the president acted on his election promises. The amnesty laws for the military were abolished and the trials against human rights abusers reopened. Most disappeared people were kidnapped in broad daylight and in public places like coffee shops or cinemas. Yet the witnesses to the kidnappings kept silent in fear of being kidnapped themselves. Today, thanks to the prosecution of human rights abusers, new evidence of what was in store for those who were kidnapped began to emerge. Photographs confirming that the Argentine army were trained to use inhuman interrogation techniques on the disappeared people were made public. My own family had suffered at the hands of the military junta in Paraguay. My uncle spent 12 months in detention when torture was routine. His name is Enrique.
Había una etapa de aislamiento absoluto antes de las sesiones de tortura.
Es la primera vez que voy a hablar. Me han preguntado mil veces de cómo pasé, incluso hasta mis hijos me han preguntado y nunca quise hablar.
Enrique was a prominent leader of the revolutionary Febrerista party that fought against the Paraguayan dictatorship.
Debo dar gracias a Dios por estar vivo.
The Paraguayan military were the first to use torture against dissidents in South America.
No estábamos preparados para la electrificación de los testículos, la introducción de elementos que convulsionaban en los genitales de hombres y mujeres.
The prosecution of human rights abusers in Argentina allowed Paraguay to look into the past as well. I convinced my uncle Enrique to come to the Palace of Justice, where the so-called Archive of Terror is kept, thousands of police files on the tortured and disappeared discovered in 1992. Enrique never knew what kind of intelligence information was gathered about him. And 32 years later, he wanted to know the reasons for his arrest.
Yo soy Enrique Sánchez y quiero mis antecedentes.
Sí, Sánchez, ¿otro apellido?
Franco.
After lying in the dusty vault for 15 years, Enrique's file, itemizing the regime's alleged evidence against him, was plucked from a shelf.
Yes, señor.
Being labeled as a terrorist ruined his life and that of his family.
No tenías cara de estar muy feliz ahí.
Nos sentamos para ver. Sentémonos ahí.
We were about to find out why the military called him a terrorist back then.
¿Te acuerdas de esa foto?
No, no me acuerdo, no me acuerdo. Este en la central de policía. Investigación.
¿Y no te acordás de cuando te sacaron la foto? ¿Qué dice la ficha?
Tiene algunos datos ciertos, como que fui detenido el 2 de enero del 75, eso es cierto. Pero no en la ciudad de San Juan Bautista, sino en la ciudad de San Ignacio, para actuar como enlace de un frente nacional en Asunción. Todo esto es falso. La asistencia de Domingo Laíno, Juan Carlos Saldívar, esto no es cierto. O sea que de algunos hechos ciertos se construye acá toda una fábula.
¿Ustedes se ponían a inventar información?
Inventaban informaciones, inventaban hechos. Inventar la fábula, famosa fábula del comunismo infiltrado en todas las organizaciones y en todas las esferas. Y por supuesto justificar el accionar de los aparatos represivos en función al combate contra el comunismo.
Y si me viene todos esos años, ¿vos te das cuenta que te están siguiendo o que te están
espiando? Sí, que estábamos controlados, sí.
Enrique decided to visit the interrogation center where he was taken in, blindfolded and shackled 32 years ago. Today, the center is a museum. The pictures of my uncle's missing friends and comrades cover the walls of the old torture chambers where they were last seen alive.
Mostrame donde está la pileta, Enrique.
Acá. Acá, esta es la pileta. Esta es la pileta. Está llenada de agua. Maniatado. Acá, así. Y te empujaban y te tiraban ahí. Caías vos de espalda, desnudo. Y encima tuyo subía un torturador en pantaloncito de fútbol, preparado para eso, de luego. Y este es el que te sometía ahí de los hombros o de la cabeza o de las orejas a ahogarte. Y algunas veces te dejaban ahí y ponían una electricidad mexicana. Ahí está. Electricidad magneto para que no sea tan de tan alto volumen el shock.
From the cell where Enrique was kept, he could hear the screams of the tortured while awaiting his next torture session in complete darkness. Across the road, there's a police station where my uncle and hundreds of other detainees were locked up if they survived the torture sessions. He spent there a whole year living in inhuman conditions.
¿Ustedes están tirados así?
Es la misma cosa, es la misma forma. Posible de imaginarse uno que en pleno siglo XXI los seres humanos no tratemos todavía de esta forma. En el submundo se come con la mano, se come en el suelo, en el mismo lugar donde se hacen las necesidades, como animales salvajes.
The military regime that ruined my uncle's life was led by General Alfredo Stroessner, a steadfast ally of the US government in its war on terror, a man who died without ever facing a court of justice.
Join me after the break when Enrique travels to Argentina in search of what happened to a female comrade.